That will be 4-on-5.
Panthers and Canucks. Florida has just taken a lead, scoring the first goal of the game, when Troy Brower takes an offensive zone penalty, giving Vancouver the opportunity to eliminate any momentum they may have had. In this clip, you'll see how the double-edged sword of aggressiveness plays out. Aggressiveness on the penalty kill is good, but when it starts to break down your penalty kill structure, that's when you get into issues. As you can see in the top left-hand corner of your screen, Vancouver has gone 0-for-3 on the power play tonight, and for good reason. Florida does a lot of great things throughout this clip that allows them to have an effective penalty kill. It's when they stray from their strategy, they get into trouble. Right off the bat, they're aggressive. They come out, they clear the zone, but are unable to get the puck down the ice. All three defending Florida Panthers respect the distance of Besser, and Vancouver's able to get into the zone. Pettersson then retrieves the loose puck, and he's able to take it all the way down to the corner, allowing both teams to set up shop. It's important to note that no Florida Panther overcommits on this play. When they begin to get aggressive, that's when they get into trouble. All the Panthers are on one side of the ice, allowing Edler to take a clear shot on the goalie. Florida is aggressive in the puck retrieval and are able to clear the zone. There needs to be a balance where they can be aggressive but not completely break down the structure of their penalty kill. The Canucks again have to enter the zone, and there's a difference this time in the penalty kill. Three Panthers attack the puck, making the zone entry difficult. Now it is sloppy, but Vancouver is able to gain the zone once again. When Vancouver's quick passing begins to come into play, Florida begins chasing the puck all over the ice, allowing things to open up for Vancouver. They are unable to generate anything because they are kept to the perimeter by the Panthers. The penalty killers hold a good structure here. They stick to their roles, they stay in their positioning, and don't give Vancouver very many options at all. This is a contrast from what you're about to see. They get over-aggressive because they think they can win the puck battle, but when they do not, the puck goes to a wide-open Pettersson, and you know the rest. Now let's look at this a little bit closer. Every Panther is on the right-hand side of the ice. No one is covering a wide-open Pettersson on the far side. Once the puck gets to him, Matheson commits early on the shot block, allowing Pettersson to choose wherever he'd like to shoot. Giving a spectacular shooter that much time and space is never going to end well for you. The kill started great for the Panthers, but everything can change in 1 second. Thanks for watching. Let me know what you think.